Hello, everybody. Welcome to this broadcast. Unfortunately, we're just now kicking things off. We had a little bit of issue getting into the lobby earlier, and we are, unfortunately, because of some several issues, basically, there is going to be no ticket. Not entirely sure. There seems to be some sort of issue with the tickets for the ESL 1, so it will not be on DotaTV, unfortunately, meaning that because we were unable to get into the lobby in time, we are not going to be casting inside from the game, but we are going to make do with what we have, as we are just going to be casting off of the current stream that's happening right now, so... Those of you guys, welcome. Apologize severely for everything that's happened so far, but game one is already underway. We got Dreamtime facing up against DK right now. Ice Ice being chased down by in July, and with the Blink Dagger he has up, Moonlight Shadow, though, should be able to give him an escape he needs, as there's going to be no dust whatsoever. Brewmaster popping his ultimate in that middle lane. So right now, DK has this like really interesting, they got a little bit of split push, they got the Ember Spirit here for the mid game mixed in with a little bit of split push. Dreamtime popping the ultimate there a little bit prematurely, burning, he's getting caught out, and the send back from Chen will be able to make sure that Luna's going to be just fine. So the Eclipse blown there, not really doing anything, but at least he was able to survive. Right now, Dreamtime falling behind in farm. They've been just kind of dealing with this constant split push of DK with the Naga Siren trying to make room for him while the Ember Spirit's sort of up in their space. There's so much mobility between the Ember, the Mirana, as well as then the Furion teleporting around the map. And then you have the Naga Siren just splitting up all the time. Dreamtime, though, they have a little bit more combat in these team fights. They're five-manning through middle right now, taking this tier one tower and just leaving the Chen to be able to jungle up, and they will have enough, as DK, not really wanting to commit to team fights just yet, will be continuing this split push. You can see the Midas as well as the phase boots are already up for Ice. Burning, meanwhile, is just trying to keep in these other side lanes pushed in as much as humanly possible, and see if they can maybe make a trade, or at the very least for Dreamtime back. Mushi trying to catch that teleport in time, but couldn't get the Sleight of Fist shackles off. So yeah, right now, 2 to 3, 15 minutes in. Both teams, it is fairly even, but DK is a bit ahead in farm right now. You could see Ember Spirit. He's had an all right time already, seeing with 1K gold, phase boots bottle, as well as a drum. He's got his basic stat items to be able to fight early. He's not going to be going for like a real fast battle fury or something like that. It's not altogether necessary yet. There, jump in, air, able to get a decent little clap here. Follow up, Nyx Assassin going to be able to burst down that Rubick. As MMY taken out of the fight immediately, Mushi on his way out. Lon, unfortunately, he already blown his song earlier, so he wasn't able to save his other support ally, and unfortunately, it's just not going to be going his way. You notice the Brewmaster's build here, he's going for a 4-0-4 build, so nothing in a Drunken Haze, trying to actually take advantage of that recent change with Brewmaster's passive, being able to get that critical and evasion guaranteed after a while. Ice being chased down once again by Angel Eye. Pop back by the Flame Break, and he will go down. And MMY once again just unable to get there to save him. Dreamtime pushing in pretty aggressively into this tier 2. Meanwhile, though, we do have our Mirana trying to do what he can to be able to push in that top lane. Lonum's going to be caught by the Brewmaster there, and will be able to... should be able to pop him there as he gets cycloned up in the air. Chased into the base. The stun will be able to land, and that means he will fall. And Brewmaster should be able to get out of here. Chen's going to be tossed back into the base here. Rubick trying to do what he can. Flame Break once again into the tier 3 tower. Doing enough damage that Mushi will be able to just finish the job there. That was still, though, a tier 2 going down. 5-4 in the favor of Dreamtime. They are putting a lot of pressure right now. They've got this early team fight lineup with the Brewmaster. They seem to really be taking advantage of the fact that they could just bully DK in these sort of five-man pushes. The biggest thing they have to fear from right now is going to be this Furion, who is trying to put pressure on the side lane. Same goes with Mirana, but that's exactly what our Batrider is for. Already having the Blink Dagger, soon to be a Force Staff, is going to be up for him before the 20-minute mark, so definitely good timing for him in that regard. And we'll see whether or not they're going to be able to take now another tower, possibly top. Moonlight Shadow is going to go down. Mirana is making the way around, but Brewmaster is going to be there, so we shouldn't be able to see Mirana solo kill. As you can see, Dreamtime have taken an early lead, taking about a 2,000 experience lead and about a 1,500 gold lead for now. Mushi, you also notice his skill build. He actually went a little bit of a split there. Early on, he went for that maxed out chain, so he's got that maxed out damage, but he also has a couple levels here. Didn't quite max out the Ember Spirit, Sleight of Fist, in favor of a couple extra levels in that Flame Guard just to be able to protect him from some of this magic damage. Ice, 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 now threatening that Tier 1 tower, and you could see Naga Sirens trying to help out as much as possible. He got those illusions, and also the Riptide just kind of safely being able to add extra push. The Tier 1 tower will go down, however, it's going to be at a trade, as Dreamtime are already pushing in the top lane and will be able to pick up the deny here. Brewmaster searching for Ice, Ice, Ice will be able to slow him down with the Drunken Haze, but with a simple Sprout and Teleport, won't be able to pick up that one. Luna did get the deny on the Tier 1 tower. Middle action, though, we do have Mushi trying to go in, finish off this Nyx Assassin, will be able to, thanks to the net arrow combo coming out from Burning and Lanham, and that will mean another Tier 1 tower. So even though the bottom tower did get denied in July, maybe thinking about trying to get that pick off, but Mushi setting it up with the sleep. Burning was thinking about maybe going for the arrow there, as Chen way too far forward there. That was some very, very greedy positioning by him, trying to catch out with the Batrider, but unfortunately the sleep just spoils everything, and he just ends up getting caught. Fortunately, he's able to save his creeps, but it's a small factor. Dreamtime now grouping up a little bit. We do have Brewmaster is working his way towards that Aghanim's, and we also almost have about halfway there to a BKB up on our Luna. So once he does have that, they're going to have a serious amount of team fight. I honestly don't know how DK are going to be able to contest them, just because this Ember Spirit, obviously not going for the fastest Battle Fury in the world, going for early fighting items with the Phase Boots and Drums. Opting not to go for that really, really quick Battle Fury just means he's going to be falling a little bit behind in farm and won't really be doing enough damage with that Sleight of Fist. So once that BKB is up, you're then going to be relying on your physical damage to try and kill that Luna, but it's just not going to be there in time. So it feels like right now Dreamtime do have a bit of advantage. They're going to be able to start pushing in. They've won a couple of team fights here. They've limited really the pushing. Oh, good catch out. Beautiful play there from Injuline. Going to be able to find Burning. Now the follow-up. Missing the impale. Should still be able to get this one. Oh, no. Nyx Assassin completely screwed the pooch on that one and won't be able to get Burning. But Injuline comes in with his extra bit of arrow. Oh my god, he was able to peel up Nyx Assassin. Burning now fighting up against Injuline where he can. Fiorian ulti being coming in, do a little bit of extra damage. Injuline will fall, and that means a 2-for-1 exchange in what should have been just a plain old pickoff there on the Mirana. Unfortunately, that is just no good in what should have been a perfect pickoff. So BKB is now going to be finished up by Luna, and that's going to mean serious business time for these pushes. You could see Burning, though, is getting a decent amount of damage, and so unfortunately he got caught there. But he is leading the net worth by just 1K over the Luna. Ember Spirit is not far behind either, sitting 8,300. So he's certainly picked up the farm a little bit in these last few minutes from when we were watching him earlier. We do have a full-up Battle Fury is going to be up for him. So I'm kind of feeling like the ticker is going here for Dreamtime. As much as I love to see a Luna going into the late game up against a Furion and Ember as well as a Mirana, I don't really place your chances too high here, especially since Brewmaster often does fall off going into the late game. Your biggest advantage is usually with a Brewmaster that 15 to 25 minute mark, maybe stretching that to 35. So that is pretty much the best you're going to hope for. Battle Fury now finished up. Mech is also going to be up for Ice, Ice, Ice. Looks like he may be trying to work his way into an Orchid from there with that Robin Magi as well as the Sobe Mask. Dreamtime staying very, very grouped up. You see the three man working their way through the jungle. They've also got the Luna who's going to be pushing in bottom. They kind of fear the early aggression coming out from the Mirana and Ember Spirit in these smaller engagements. But I think the full 5v5, they've got a little bit more powerful. You see the smart blockout of the Ancients, and that's going to be one of the main sources of income there for an Ember Spirit, is if you can get really a good 4 or 5 stack of Ancients, Ember Spirit with that Battle Fury clears through it so quickly. The more Ancient stacks there are, the faster he clears through it with those Battle Fury splashes. But so very, very wise decision there from Dreamtime, trying to block that out as much as possible. And we do have them attempting to five-man their way into bottom. They're a little bit scattered right now, but They should be, at least. I thought they were going to be five-manning into the Tier 2, but looks like they're going to be backing up. Lincoln's is now up for the Marana. So, again, more heavier split push. This means this Marana is going to be feeling a little bit safer going up against this Batrider and trying to push in Mushi. He does have a little bit of deep push with that Sleight of Fist, especially now that the Battle Fury is up, but not quite enough to stop this Tier 2 from going down. Double damage is up on air, and that means DK probably not looking to take this fight. Ember Spirit just throws out more Sleight of Fist where he can, but Tier 2 will fall, and Dreamtime showing no signs of slowing just yet. Batrider's going to be able to grab Mushi. Mushi's so squishy without his Ember, his Flame Guard there, just falls apart under the onslaught. DK are trying to split push as much as they can, but they know they can't take this and are going to have to back up and try and defend this Tier 3. Unfortunately, it seems Mushi not going to be up in time. Iron Jow jumps in, gets the double clap going in on Lanham. Lanham getting low, but fortunately, the Moonlight Shadow is going to be able to protect him. Dust going out a little bit late. They see Burning there in the back. Impale missing, unfortunately, for the Nyx Assassin. As there goes that Lincoln's as well. Mana Bird and... Oh, no! Lanham! He just caught him out. Dreamtime, we're trying to back their way out. They don't have the Brewmaster Ultimate. This could be a big fight here for DK. Now, locking in. Great Sprout. There goes the Ultimate coming out from the Luna, protecting herself as much as possible. The Ensnare was holding her in. There goes the mech. And now they can turn this around. They've already picked off the Naga Siren, who's got a quick buyback. Batrider trying to finish off MMY. Air's going to be able to hit the clap, and that will be able to finish him off as he gets a big critical. Air on his way out as much as he can. Burning locked up. Looks like Air's going to fall as they were able to catch him out with the Ensnare. They need to get as many kills as possible here, though, because they took a large amount of building damage. They might just check in July. He does have a four staff, though, and Ice, unable to really catch him out. But this means DK now have a serious advantage with the Brewmaster and the Luna down. They're going to take control of this game by being able to go and do Roshan. This is really important because you could feel this lineup from Dreamtime. They were coming online so early. They had all this big team fight, but that was just a beautiful play from DK. They tried to just harass Dreamtime as much as humanly possible, make sure that Brewmaster didn't get a great initiation and kill a couple of heroes. And as soon as they were on their way out, instantly, Lanham just pops that Naga Siren Ultimate and slows down everybody. Dreamtime unable to get out in time, and they got a couple of big pickoffs, and that means with that Aegis, they might just be able to take on the next team fight up against Dreamtime. It looks like DK with that Aegis almost want to be more aggressive. I was expecting them to play their time a little bit more and just try and farm up maybe a second Battle of Fury for Mushi, maybe finish off an actual damage item for a Marana, because we don't have a whole lot of damage coming out of her just yet. Despite the fact that she's top in net worth, it's always the problem with a Marana is you come online with damage a little bit late, especially if you're forced to go Lincoln's in this sort of situation. He's got the treads, he's got the Hand of Midas, and just the Lincoln's for now. But once he gets that one good damage item, you're then kind of up as a Potum carry, being able to match the early magical damage that you do with a good amount of right clicks, a single target. And you kind of need that right now for the Luna. We saw it earlier with the BKB pop. They had a really good play where they ensnared up that Naga, that BKB'd up Luna. And Marana was just sitting in the back, just throwing down those shots at 600 range, just pop, 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 making that Luna get a little bit low. Ancient stack going to be cleared here from Dreamtime. Luna's trying to clear through it with the Bouncing Glaives. Air is helping out where he can. But honestly, he's not going to be building into much after this Aghanim's. That's kind of your peak as a Brewmaster. You could certainly get a lot of auras. Is fairly often picked up on a Brewmaster with the... AC as well as Vlad's being common pickups for Brewmasters. And I'm sure that's going to be his build going into the future. But honestly, your peak as a Brewmaster is once you finish that Axe. The rest is just kind of luxury, but doesn't impact as much. Now, of course, the change to the passive makes, I suppose, Brewmaster a little bit more reliable, especially with the change to the Axe upgrade. I think that was a bit of a buff, especially like being able to get a good critical or a second clap. Very, very devastating. But there's that Orchid finished up by the Furion, and now they might just have the initiation to be able to counter out some of Dreamtime there. Meaning if they actually lead with the Naga Siren Sleep, they have a chance to be able to catch out that Brewmaster, silence him in the beginning of the fight, and if there's no Brewmaster Ultimate, there goes so much of Dreamtime's plan for these team fights. Blink Dagger, Force Staff, as well as the BKB is going to be up soon for the Batrider. We've got 3,800 gold up on the Marana. I'm interested to see what his skill build is going to be here. I would personally really favor Adesso right now, just to be able to apply that like really, really single target damage on just the Luna, if possible. Looks like they're going to Moonlight Shadow up top lane. They're going to try and pick off Luna here, and with the Orchid, the arrow's going to be able to land. Smart decision making. They knew with the BKB there was a chance they were going to see BKB teleport. In order to dodge that gank, but fortunately, with a surprise arrow, the reaction's just not quite fast enough for the Luna, and that means she will fall. Gem is up on, is up, so they're going to be able to try and take a little bit of map control where they can, but DK really just kind of outmaneuvering Dreamtime, and the Luna, you're not making much item correction. I mean, like, especially with that one gank. There's so much pressure on the map now. Dreamtime had that one push, but after they lost both of their big cores there, the Brewmaster as well as Luna, and in the process gave up Roshan, they lost just so much pushing power because now they have to deal with either fighting up against an Aegis or even more split push coming out from DK. In fact, you have to facing both. So the next team fight, if they try and go in for another five-man push like this, they're going to be punished heavily by DK. By not only having their base, their tier 2s and their tier 3s threatened, but also being at a disadvantage with basically 6 lives, potentially even 7 or 8 up for DK. It's not just a simple 5 versus 5, but with the Aegis as well as buybacks, DK can just throw numbers at Dreamtime, despite the fact that Dreamtime should have the superior team fight. But that's not going to last for long here. Blink Dagger's up from the Nyx Assassin, so a little bit of extra initiation. We have another 3,200 gold on Mushi. Interested to see whether or not he builds into the critical here, or if he favors his second Battle Fury. Not really sure which one you want to go here. As I'm not too convinced one way or the other, Luna's going to be able to finish off that Manta. So there's that next damage item that we soon should see at Battle Fury after. Not a Battle Fury, goddamn. A Butterfly after that, the other B word. Battle Fury, Butterfly, they're both BFs. In July, going to be able to catch out Lana. Missing the Impale once again, we'll be able to finish him off though with a Vendetta. And that's a big pickoff. They already had that middle lane sort of pushing in. If they can keep up the pressure, maybe they can win that one team fight that'll be able to take a Rax advantage, and then they'll feel a big weight off their chest. But as always, Ice is constantly pushing in bottom. And KB, all right, that's actually a very, very smart decision. I thought maybe Burning would have enough to be able to go a little bit greedy with his build, but MKB, still really solid right clicks as well, is going to be counteracting the Butterfly before it's even picked up. So smart decision there from Burning. And Dreamtime, once again, force back. Now, we do have a Luna as well as a Batrider going into the late game, but again, the Chen and the Brewmaster not going to be that helpful. But Aegis is going to go down in just another 2 seconds. Dreamtime, they either have the option to try and push while the Aegis is down, or maybe try and secure the next Roshan. But they have to be careful of these constant pickoffs. As you can see, DK are trying to go once again. They see this lane is pushing in. They know somebody's going to defend it. There's going to be a rotation somewhere, as there's nobody bottom, there's nobody middle. They expected to see somebody there, but Air, maybe just Spidey senses tingling a little bit, doesn't go for that push just yet. And maybe they actually did see it. Clap being used. Just be able to kill those damn treants. Take away that vision as much as possible. And I am reading the chat right now. It looks like they're going to be trying to solve as much of the it looks like they're going to be solving the tickets issue for next time. Looks like the admins didn't actually have a admin ticket, so that was the issue for this game one. That's why it's not on Dota TV. So apologies for that one, guys. And hopefully we will be in the lobby as well. We got What else? In July, he's trying to get his BKB, but they haven't really been finding a whole lot of pickoffs of late. DK just seemed to be really outmaneuvering them left and right. Oh, in July, looks like he was able to pick off Ice. That's a big play, though, because they're already pushing in this bottom lane. They just defeated one of the big split pushers. That top lane is not very far in. So DK, they're burning an MMY. They won't be able to threaten this top lane, this tier 3, and force anybody back in time. And Dreamtime, with the Aegis down, maybe they can take this. They're going to be dealing up against buybacks once again, but the tier 3 is already low. And once the tier 3 is down, that's when the Luna gets real deadly. Manta being popped. Initiation. Burning getting caught out. That Lincoln's only saves him from so much. The impale still going to be able to land. Because of that slight change, tier 3 does go down, but our Luna is getting a little bit low, trying to earn up. Back away if he can. Lucent Beam being stolen in. Now Brewmaster's going to jump in. Clap really aggressively far in there. Is going to pop that Brewmaster ultimate, try and catch somebody out, but DK do a good job limiting anybody being caught out. Mushi's going to go down, though, as they catch him out with the Nyx Assassin as well as the Batrider. We now have the Brewmaster just trying to zone everybody else away. They already take that bottom rank. Dreamtime now going to move into the middle lane as well, trying to utilize that Brewmaster ultimate to buy them as much time to get some building damage down, but they cannot afford to get caught. You know what the Naga Siren did last time, and he's going to do it again. Throwing down that sleep, three heroes caught in a circle here, and Mushi, he's going to get some good Sleight of Fist damage. Perfect Sprout, locking them in together. Arrow's going to come in. He's not going to be able to land on the Luna. The attempt at a teleport, so much right-click damage, though. It's too much, and he falls under the weight of Ice's right-clicks. Now Lanham has that gem picked up earlier and is going to be able to chase down the Nyx Assassin. Gets the blink away, though. Still caught out by the ensnare, and he will go down as the arrow finishes him off. So they were able to claim that bottom racks, and that's great. Hey, great for Dreamtime. They've got a little bit too greedy. Their Brewmaster ultimate, they didn't get out in time. And Naga Siren, just like last time when they tried to push in, once again, Naga Siren was in a position to be able to catch them with the sleep on their way out, and then turn that into a couple of big pickoffs. And now it's DK's turn to get aggressive. Pushing into this tier 2. Two man down. 20 seconds until both the Luna as well as the Nyx Assassin are up. They obviously won't be able to do trade Arax, but they will be able to get themselves a little bit of extra gold in and also be able to take Roshan, which is another big factor. Last time they picked up that Aegis, it was a good, like, just 6-minute zoning factor where basically Dreamtime could not go in for another one of those early pushes like they would have liked to, just because they would have been at such a disadvantage. This next Aegis is going to do the exact same thing. Dreamtime, though, I'm not sure if they can afford to go into the 40-45-minute mark. They are trying to interrupt. Angel Eye going in deep, though. Aegis is picked up by the Ember Spear, but Ice being dragged away. Looks like he should go down here as he's dragged into the rest of Dreamtime. All of DK are now trying to get out. Mushi locked himself on the cliff, though. He leaped up. They might be able to kill him here. They're trying to keep some vision up. They're getting their small little nukes, and he will go down here. Burning can do nothing to stop this one. Ice, he bought back. He's coming back into this one, but this could be bad if he goes down a second time. Dreamtime now popping the Embers, Brewmaster Ultimate where he can, zoning out the rest of those heroes, and Ice will go down a second time, down for 80 seconds, and this could be a complete disaster there for DK. They do still have that Aegis advantage, and of course Ember Spirit is going to be playing havoc on Dreamtime's attempt to push in, but I believe they do have enough team fight right now to try and push in through middle while Ice is down. And looks like they think the exact same thing. If they can get another pickoff there with that Batrider Lasso, it should be up here in a short amount of time as they push in. If they can get another pickoff like that, they could be golden. Two sets of racks down, and DK, two sets of racks down is kind of like the sort of signal that, hey, this game's kind of over. There are very, very few teams that have come back from a two racks advantage. Sleep going off. They tried to grab Mushi, but Lanham's going to say no to that one with the sleep. However, they're going to have a hard time stopping this push. Dreamtime backing up a little bit, knowing that the Sleight of Fist was going to play some havoc with them if they grouped up a little bit too much. Tier 3 is going to go down. And once again, Luna, ooh, good attempt there from Nyx Assassin, trying to catch out Mushi, but it wasn't in time. Lasso dragging back Nyx Assassin. Well played by Rubik, but it might be at the cost of the mid-raxes. Luna not wanting to go down here. Burning's getting close. BKB's going to be activated. Turns around and now trying to fight a little bit. Mushi gets a little bit low. Is trying to jump away to his remnant. Rubik's going to go down at the same time. Moonlight Shadow buys them a little bit of time. Can they finish off this melee Rax in time? It will go down as Manta's going to focus it. Naga Siren getting a little bit low as the second Brewmaster ultimate comes in.
and trying to force back the rest of DK. Not going to be able to finish off Ice, though. And now Luna's being chased out by Mushi. They might have gotten that melee Rax, but it seems like Luna's probably going to go down here. Mushi catches out the Chen, and Luna was able to get away. So DK, they do get pickoffs, but it's not really worth it. As Brewmaster, as well as Luna, should be able to get out. Ice may finish off Air here. Burning, throwing down the arrow. Air does a great job dodging it there. Doesn't have them link up in time, being held in by the Sprout. Now blocked off by the Treants. Well played by Ice there. And they do get the Brewmaster, but it's still an issue. The Luna survived. And that's my biggest threat right now. Mushi looks like he should be able to have a Daedalus in a short amount of time. And this is a damn close game because DK are so close to being able to just defeat Dreamtime in a lot of these team fights, but can't quite make it work. They just need a little bit of extra time. Items, a couple extra items left. One big damage item on Mirana, and then you've got a ton of right-click up against, like, Butterfly that was picked up by the Luna. Useless up against that Mirana. Like, it's going to be obviously a lot of extra damage and will be able to protect from some of the other right-clicks, but if that Luna gets the opportunity, some sort of ensnare being thrown down, and just, again, just throwing down those right-clicks on the Luna, that HP pool, man, it's going to drop real heavily for the Luna. See how even the graphs are right now in both gold and experience. It is just very, very minimal lead for either one. 39 minutes into the game, 18-17. Brewmaster is going to be up in just another 2 seconds. And we'll see whether or not Dreamtime. Looks like they almost want to just 5-man to top and try and end this game right here, right now. And I can't blame them too much. You don't want this game to push much longer. Brewmaster looks like he wants to be able to go a BKB here. And in fact, he almost has it, so that might just be able to ensure that he doesn't get orchided up, make sure that he always gets off one of those big ults. Of course, last team fight with the way they fought around the Roche Pit area, and then another fight in the middle, he was able to get basically 2 Brewmaster ultimates in one really, really long extended team fight, but that was kind of a special circumstance. Dreamtime. Backing away from their push at top lane, they force back DK. That's the most they can do. And really, they know they want some sort of pickoff because they don't necessarily know whether or not they can take a full-on 5v5 just yet. 40 minutes in. Dreamtime are going to be smoking up to that top lane, maybe seeing if they can pick off Mushi. But Lanham does have his Naga Siren Sleep up and will be ready. When they try and initiate like that, Injilite goes up, BKB is activated, and that means the Naga Siren ultimate won't do much to stop it. He does still catch out the Chen, but they were able to finish off Mushi. Now here comes the Eclipse going off, doing a lot of damage to Lanham, almost able to finish him off, and there goes that Brewmaster clip, sealing the deal. And just like that, Dreamtime, Nyxed Assassin stun on 2 was great, but they're still pushing him back. Mushi still down. Bernie's going to fall. Dreamtime, they just did it. They just finish off DK, and Dreamtime will take the first game up against DK in this best of 3 in the ESL Chinese qualifier. Well played by DK. Very, very well done. We'll be back in just a couple minutes, guys. We're going to play some commercials. We'll be back with game 2.